Chemistry, oh, I think, no?
No.
No.
Earth?
To the left?
That's the chemistry one.
There's that same one again.
But now it's branching out.
Yeah, that's an ethanol molecule with iodine tagging along to hydrogen somehow, probably due to data covalent bonding, which probably doesn't mean anything to you. But I haven't got a clue what the squiggly bits on the sides are.
Well,
there's something else behind you.
No, that's... there's something about this that's keeping me here. I don't know why, but... is there any element of, like, kind of fantasy in this? Because I'm kind of getting the idea of, like, the Earth's core branching out kind of thing. Yeah, that's what I get from that. Which could also mean then chemistry is getting mixed in with it.
Hmm.
So chemistry and, you know, science and magic. But that's just me. And then that. What the... is that a squid?
I don't know, but that there might be a carbon monoxide. Depends whether that's a sea or no.
I don't
it
think
it's like a blob.
Yeah, I think it's just paint splatter.
Mm.
That it looks kind of like a squid, like body there,
yeah.
Head, and then that.
No, no, that blob looks like the head, and there's all the tentacles.
Yeah.
Mm.
No idea what. Oh, there's more. There's just more. Roots of a tree, maybe?
Mm-hmm. And then
tree.
A tree.
All cracks in the rock. Paint cracks in the rock.
Well, another thing is maybe that since they've got chemistry and physics imbued into this, there might be some little bits of biology in
mm-hmm.
it as well. Because, say, I don't know much about that, but...
oh.
I do know that they tend to use different shapes and stuff whatnot to portray more complex molecules and stuff.
What was that noise?
I don't know, but I'm not really willing to go back in and find out. Because I'm still convinced something's going to jump out and scare me.
No, it's not.
Can we swim?
You'll die, again.
But there's a boat. I suppose if we go up and over... figure out how to get up
to your left.
Mm. I just realised I walked in a cave, stuck to the left wall, and I came out of the same entrance. That just confused me. Oh wait, no, never mind. I figured it out. It's a nice stream.
Mm.
It's weird, it's starting to get a bit darker.
There's quite a lot of biblical references in this as well. Well, it sounds like biblical.
He still maintains he wasn't drunk, but tired. I can't make the judgment or the distinction
anymore.
Damn.
Can you let me back up?
I was drunk when
no.
I landed here, and
no,
tired,
I just walk up
too.
Through the stream now.
I walked up the cliff path in near darkness, and camped in the bay where the trawler lies beached. It was only at dawn that I saw the bothy, and decided to make my temporary lodgings there. I was expecting just the aerial, and a transmitter stashed in a weatherproof box somewhere on the mount. It had an air of uneasy permanence to it. Like all the other buildings here, erosion seems to have evaded it completely.
Did anyone else just hear that noise?
Yeah.
Yes. What did you hear?
Muttering. Going from right to left. Units... what's that?
Three.
Is
units three chemistry.
Like, units from chemistry.
Wait, to the left of that rock on the ground. Like, go around it and look at the ground.
Mm. Paint.
There's something on the rock, actually.
No, it's just splat. Nah, it's just not here. It's not really visible.
There's nothing in that gap in the sage, just a drop. I remember that, I think.
That's where the car would be down the bottom. Can't go up there, can we?
Maybe we'll do it.
Yeah. Let's take a quick gander up here.
Nope.
Unless I could kind of skittle. Nah, I can't get up there. So just another chemistry thing up there, that's where we came from. Kinda wish you could move a bit faster, to be honest. Ooh, flowers. Yeah, it's definitely getting darker.
Yeah.
Oh.
I assume you heard that too.
Yeah.
That was just wind tunneling off the top, wasn't it?
As far as we know. Could be a bird.
Mm.
Oh, well, that looks safe. Oh, bloody.
First chapter down.
Oh yeah, it's in chapters.
Four chapters.
Dear Esther, I have now driven the stretch of the M5 between Exeter and Bristol over 21 times. But although I have all the reports and all the witnesses and have cross-referenced them within a millimeter using my ordnance survey maps, I simply cannot find the location. You'd think there would be marks to serve as some evidence. It's somewhere between the turnoff for Sanford and the welcome break services. But although I can always see it in my rearview mirror, I have as yet been unable to pull ashore.
What?
Exactly. Memory's blurring. It's blurring travelling on the road to travelling to the island.
Let's go take down, go down and have a look at the boats. See if we can get inside them.
Talk about the buildings of unnatural standing or whatever.
Oh! Oh! Black shadow!
Why?
Where?
There's a black shadow moving up there. I think if you. Yeah!
Oh shit!
If you don't look directly at them.
Look directly at them, will disappear.
Yeah. So it's always in your peripherals. That's creepy.
It's a creeper that's just standing there.
No, it was moving up.
No, it stopped.
Watching me. I think those are to guide you where you're actually meant to be going. Possibly.
Maybe. But if they're that obscure,
then it'll be a case of if you're exploring, then you see it, then you go chase it.
And then it disappears.
But yeah, you know,
maybe they're shadows of past memories.
Still there. I kind of want to go and follow it, to be honest.
Nothing along there.
Right, let's just go and find the shadow. Will you pick up the damn pace?
Or maybe you yourself are a shadow and the other shadow is the person. The actual person.
Don't confuse things even more than they already are.
You. What?
And again,
just
on the topic of paradoxes.
What is a paradox?
Because you're not the person, you're looking at the person that you are.
Well, no, you're not looking at who you are, you're looking at who you're helping.
I'm trying to keep him in the peripheral, see if he starts moving again.
got from that was you're not you.
You are nothing, no. Kind of thing. You are just an
observer. I'm saying.
Now he's gone.
That maybe you are not. You know, I'll just leave it. That might make more sense to you what you've done.
An imagined answer phone message. The tires are flat, the wheel spins loosely, and the brake fluid has run like ink over this map, staining the landmarks and rendering the coastline mute, compromised. Where you saw galaxies, I saw only bruises cut into the cliff by my lack of sobriety.
It's gone.
God
damn
it!
There's up there.
There was another path back here.
Did you see that? What was it talking about? Cars. Damaged cars. Brake fluid leaking.
Possibly, but the wreckage that we saw at the beginning, it could have just been washed ashore.
Metal has a tendency not to float, though.
Aluminium is really light, and cars have a lot of air pockets in them.
It's a possibility. Really, phone?
Because with a strong current, it could potentially float.
Let me pick up the phone. Hello? Piece of shit. Cold, cooling bastards. Rotten hell. Assume. So, dear Esther. Oh, that's the thing over there.
Yeah.
That's kind of cool.
It was on that little island.
Wait, can you see any more shadows, actually?
That's what I'm looking for. If I turn around, there's one in my face.
Wait,
I'm going to scream.
Wait. Turn it slightly to the left. Stop.
That's a beacon. It's a boy.
Boy.
That's in the ocean anyway. This is just leading me back to where the way I came in. So I must have to go up there.
Yeah. See, now our theory of what they are is nonsense.
Or maybe they're leading you away from where you meant to go to distract you.
Possibly.
Well, that's only been one incident. We can't really make a hypothesis just from that.
Well, we can make a hypothesis. We can't get a conclusion from it.
True. There goes me using big words. I'll just stick to the small ones.
I had kidney stones, and you visited me in the hospital. After the operation, when I was still half submerged in anesthetic, your outline and your speech both blurred. Now my stones have grown into an island and made their escape, and you have been rendered opaque by the car of a drunk.
Stop speaking in riddles, man! So, he had kidney stones, he's ill. So, obviously, all these narratives are coming from the diary of a dying man.
Of what I've learned, I think it's actually from letters.
From letters to Dear Esther.
Which is why they start with Dear Esther. Oh wait, what the? Turn around. Look at that big ass hole in the ground.
Oh shit.
Don't go there yet.
It's a pothole.
That's where I went. That's where I went after this. And it leads to the next chapter, I think?
I've begun my ascent on the windless slope of the western side. The setting sun was an inflamed eye squeezing shut against the light shone in by the doctors. My neck is aching through constantly craning my head up to track the light of the aerial. I must look downwards, follow the path under the island to a new beginning.
The pot.
Does that make any sense to you?
It seems like it's trying to tell me that the pothole leads to the next area. It's telling me that's where we need to go. It's as if the narrative is in two parts. One is the letters, that's he's speaking to someone else, and one is him talking to himself as we're going through it.
And they blur together. Do you think that we're